What is going on, guys? Dealing with Dalton here, and welcome to episode 4 of From the Closet to Profit, the series where I'm taking 2 shoes out of my personal closet, selling them online, and seeing if we can snowball that into a profitable reselling business. For those of you who are new to the series, last week we ended up with 15 pairs in our inventory, as well as $106 left to spend on new inventory. And this week we definitely keep the ball rolling. We find some amazing stuff, as well as have our second giveaway of the series. So make sure to stick around to the end of the video for more information on that. And with that being said, let's hop into this week's footage. So before we hop into the sourcing that we're gonna do this week, I have a quick sales update. So we ended last week's episode with $106.29 in the shoe fund. Since the end of last week's episode, I sent out an offer of $25 plus discounted shipping on the Cole Haans that we picked up for, I believe, just like $2.50, and somebody accepted the offer. So after I sent out an offer for $25, and after the Poshmark fees and the shipping discount, we're left with $17.54 left over. Adding that into the shoe fund, we now have $123.83 to go sourcing with. So now that we have one more sale under our belt and a little bit more cash to go spend, let's see if we can find some more profitable inventory to source this week. All right, so it is Tuesday. I didn't think I was gonna have a chance to go source for this series until Wednesday, plus the store that we had success in last week, they run new sales every Wednesday. So I figured I'd wait till Wednesday and hopefully we can score big again there. But it's, again, Tuesday, and I have a bunch of stuff that I'm bringing to Goodwill to drop off at the donation. So I figured I might as well pop in and see what they got, because again, we have $123 and I believe 83 cents in the fund right now. So I'm not gonna just come to Goodwill and not go in and shop and see if we can't find anything. Depending on how we do or how I'm doing on time, I might pop over to another thrift store in this area, but I wouldn't really count on it. I'm hoping tomorrow we can score pretty big. So gonna pop inside and see if we can't find anything. So this clip is really all I need to roll to explain this Goodwill location for you guys. It's always so hit or miss. Sometimes with these type of locations, you can find higher quality inventory that you just need to pay up a little bit for, but that's what makes it hit or miss, because 9 times out of 10, they don't really know what they're pricing. So unfortunately didn't walk away with anything for the Closet to Profit challenge. I did pick up a few pairs of shoes for my personal store, but I didn't feel comfortable spending our shoe fund on those shoes because they're typically slower sellers, and plus I had to pay up for them. I paid basically $10 a pair for 5 pairs of shoes in there, and I don't really expect any of them to sell quick enough for me to warrant spending the $50 from our shoe fund. So again, tomorrow I'm gonna come back out, hit up the store that we had luck with last week. They're gonna be running new sale colors, so hopefully we have as much luck as we did last week. So see you guys then. So right before I left the Goodwill, I hopped on Facebook Marketplace, and I actually found a really good deal that is right next to where I am at. So I'm gonna pop over there, and I think we're gonna spend some of the shoe fund on one pair of shoes. I'm paying up a little bit for these, but in a second I'll show you exactly why. So just left the Facebook Marketplace deal, paid $20 for these New Balance 990s. So our shoe fund is still up over $100 for tomorrow, so can't complain about that. And if you weren't aware, the New Balance 990s are one of the most popular New Balance models. They also make 991s, 992s, 993s. Basically any made in the USA New Balance is gonna sell really well and really fast. I just found a pair of this exact model in blue over the weekend at the flea market, paid $5 for them, listed them the same day, and then they sold on Sunday for $100. So as you can see, they have a very high sell-through rate, a high demand, and demand a very high price. So I think this was a good investment for our Closet to Profit series. $20, hopefully within the week, I can have these flipped into at least, again, I'm listing on the lower end to try to turn the money as fast as possible, but they'll still sell for at least $80, I'm hoping. So super pumped about this find, and I'll catch up with you guys tomorrow and see if we can spend the rest of our $100 shoe fund. All right, so a day has passed. I just pulled up to the first stop. This is the one that we had good luck with last week. Already got an offer on those New Balances that I picked up on Facebook Marketplace. I listed them last night, and this morning I woke up to a $60 offer on Poshmark, which is decent, but I know we can get more for them than that. So hopefully I can spend most of that in here on some quality inventory. So let's pop in and see what we find.
So just a few things to go over while we're in the store. I found these OnClouds, which is an amazing brand if you guys don't know of it, but it had just a little too rough a heel drag. Still probably could have sold it for good money, but decided to pass. When you're picking up golf shoes, always make sure that the spikes are all in good condition. And then, as you can see, we found a lot of shoes at this stop. Very full cart at the checkout line. And then I wanted to show the colors that were half off. Red and blue, as well as green, was 25%.
All right, so I definitely spent way too much money in there. Kind of a struggle with the challenge is if I'm walking into a thrift store and it's got a bunch of very profitable shoes, I don't want to leave them behind just because I'm doing the challenge. So I'm going to split this haul up. Whatever I can fit into my budget, I'm going to use those for the closet to profit, and then everything else I'm just going to sell in my regular store. So I spent $175. When I get back to my apartment, I'm going to run through the receipt. Also, I wanted to do two transactions, but this place makes that kind of difficult because they have a bunch of shoes that are only singles, and when you get to the register, you have to ask for the additional one, and they got to take it all the way to the back, and it just takes forever. Plus, they're cash only, so it would just make things too difficult. So I went and did everything on one transaction, and I'm going to split it up when I get back to my apartment. But before I go back, we're going to stop by Walmart because I need cleaning supplies, and I'll show you what we are picking up. So part of that haul was these Vans, and the soles of Vans are a little rigid. They aren't smooth. So when you use the magic eraser on them, it makes the magic eraser fall apart a lot faster. So what I prefer to use on these kind of midsoles is acetone. So we're going to stop by Walmart, pick up some acetone, as well as we don't have anything to clean the bottoms of the shoes yet. So these aren't that bad, but like you can see in here, there's some dirt caked into the tread. So we need to get a pick or something. I'm not sure if they sell them at Walmart, honestly, but we're gonna find out. A pick or something to pick the dirt out, as well as a dry brush to just wipe bottoms of shoes down to get all the dirt and stuff off of them without having to like run them under the sink like we have been lately. So we're gonna pick those three things up, head back to my apartment, and I'll show you exactly what I picked up for the challenge.
So here's what the acetone looks like. You can find that in the beauty department. And then in the tools, I found the picks. The $7 one is the one I have at home. But there was a $4 option right here that was basically the same thing. And then this other $4 option had a file in the end. You could use those to erase the Sharpie off the bottom if you decided to go with those. And then here's just a regular brush.
All right, so just popped in the Walmart, paid $9.08 on three things to add to our cleaning repertoire. I grabbed this acetone, as you've seen. This is like what I said is great for cleaning the midsoles of like Converse and Vans. Decided to grab these picks. As you've seen, they had a few options. The only other one, I was trying to decide between these and the ones with like a file on the end of them. The other one that had was a pack of four, the bigger handled ones. That's what I have right now. I figured these would be nice because of how long they are. So you can use them to like stick down into the shoes and get like stickers and stuff out. Decided to go with these. These were only like $4, I think. The acetone was like $3. And lastly, just a regular old brush to brush the dirt off the bottom of the soles. So again, these three items, I already have all of them. So make sure to stick around to the end of the video. I'll be giving these away to one of you guys who answers the question of the day. And if you're new to the series, going forward, every time I buy something to invest into the business, whether it be cleaning supplies, photo supplies, storage supplies, anything like that, I'll be giving them away to one person who comments on the question of the day at the end of the video. So make sure to stick around till the end of the video and answer today's question.
All right, so now that I'm back, let's talk about that thrift store stop. I went in there with $103.83 to spend. I knew that we would be stopping at Walmart to get cleaning supplies afterwards, so I wanted to keep my buy cost under $95. But when I got to shopping, I rounded it down to 18 pairs that I really wanted to pick up. Obviously, with that budget, I could not afford it, but I still wanted to pick the additional pairs up for my main eBay, Poshmark, Mercari stores. So I went ahead and purchased all of them. Again, just because of some complications on the way the store worked, I couldn't do two. Well, I could have, but I decided not to do two transactions. So when I got home, I decided to go through what I picked up. And based on what they were and how fast I thought they'd sell, I narrowed it down to what I would have picked up if I literally only went in there with $103 to my name, $95 to my name to spend. So first, I'm gonna go over the shoes that I would have passed on, but I still picked up for my main store, and I'll explain why for each of them. So to start, I got two pairs of these Allegria slides. They were $18.18, blue was half off, so they came down to about $9.09 plus tax. Great price for Allegrias, but just in my experience, they're a little bit slower of sellers. Sometimes they will sell quick. Sometimes I'm sitting on them for 30 plus days. So I didn't want that to be the case with anything from the closet to profit challenge. So I decided to only pick these up for my main store. If you find these out in the wild and you are prepared to either take a lower price or wait a while for a higher price, these are definitely a good pickup. I always pick up Allegria every time I find them, as long as the price is right. Next up, I grabbed a pair of these Bontrager cycling shoes. Cycling shoes sell super well for me, and Bontrager is one of the main brands that I sell when I'm selling cycling shoes. Unfortunately, these were $28.28, half off, came down to $14. So I didn't want to invest $14 into a single pair of shoes. The sell-through rate on this exact model wasn't amazing. I don't think that any of them have even sold on eBay, but knowing what I know about cycling shoes and how well they sell, and knowing this brand, especially since it's brand new, I know I can sell these for at least $40 to $50 plus shipping. So I went ahead and picked these up. Again, might be sitting on them for a while, might sell quick, but I didn't want to take that risk with the closet to profit funds. Next is just a simple pair of Skechers slip-ons. Again, they were $5.50 after the half off discount. Super good condition. I love selling Skechers. I always want to get them around that $5 price point. But again, if you want to demand a higher sell price, you're going to have to sit on them for a little longer, because the market for most Skechers is kind of flooded. There's a bunch of listings. A bunch of them have sold for a cheaper price. So I went ahead and only picked these up for my main store. Didn't want to sit on them. Next, we got a pair of Star Wars Crocs. These things are probably going to sell almost instantly, but they were $9 plus 25% off. So came down to like $7. I'm going to say that I might just over double my money on these. So the return wasn't quite there. I would have rather spent it in other places with the closet to profit funds. Next is these Youth Merrell or Merrell hiking boots. They are, again, $5.50 after the half off discount. The size on them is a size 2. Typically with youth shoes, the sizings that sell the best is anything under 1. So more of your toddler sizes, anything from infant up to 13C sells better than your youth 1 to youth 5 or 6. I think people just like spending money on their babies more than they like spending money on their older kids. So that that need to buy shoes all the time kind of fades. So I definitely see more success with those smaller sizes. Next is these ASICS Gel Nimbus 15s. They are a great colorway, but they were $15 plus a 25% discount. So still over $10. I didn't really want to pay over $10 for these ASICS, but they were in good condition. And at a decent price point, I decided to pick them up for my main store. And here we got these Crocs. They are a more rare edition. Some of these were selling over $150. Some of them were selling in like the $60 to $100 range, but they didn't have a great sell-through rate. And I know I'm probably gonna sit on these for a while to demand that higher 100 plus sale, but they are in perfect condition. They were $18.18 plus 25% off, so still around $15 for these. And lastly, I decided to pass on these Doc Martens at $16.16 plus half off. So they were only $8. But the reason I decided to pass, Doc Martens, as most of you probably know, is a great brand to look out for when you're thrifting. But this model in particular doesn't sell super well. I'm still gonna make money on it. But the main thing is the size. It's a women's size 5. And just like with the kids' shoes, adult shoes have size ranges that sell better than others as well. With women's shoes, it's typically your size 7 to 9.5, and then the 6, 6.5, and size 10 sell okay. Anything outside of that range, you're gonna be sitting on for a little longer in most cases. And then with men's shoes, it's typically size 9 to size 13, excluding the half sizes over 11. So like 11.5 and 12.5 typically don't do as well, but everything else from 9 to 13 sell pretty well. Anything outside of that is typically gonna sell a little bit slower. So that's the main reason I decided to pass on these, trying to only look for shoes that have a higher sell-through rate. All right, now on to what we picked up for the actual Closet to Profit series. Gonna start off with a pair that I actually paid up for, and you just seen a pair of these. It's these New Balance 990s. I think these are the V3s. So another pair of New Balance 990s. These were, tag's not on here, but they were $28. No discount on these, but these will sell super fast. I typically sell them within 48 hours for around $100. So this will be a quick 30 into around $100 sell. So definitely worth paying up for these. Then I picked up these Vans that you've seen in the car. They were $9 plus a 25% discount. As some of you who follow me may know, Vans is one of my favorite brands to pick up. They sell super well, especially these this old school model, as well as the Skate High. Those are the two main sellers for me, but these are in great condition. Just going to use that acetone we bought to clean up these sides, and they'll be ready to list. And then here's another one that was $9 plus 25% discount, just these New Balance 860s. This is a pretty good model. I like that it's a bright colorway, so that should help it sell. All we really need to do is use the pick that we just bought to get some rocks out of the tread, and then a magic eraser to clean up the midsoles, and these will be ready to list as well. Next up, I picked up a pair of brand new Vionic wedges. Still got the factory tape or whatever this is around the tips. These were $18.18, half off, so like $9.09. Again, Vionic is a great brand. Next up, another pair of Brooks. These are the Revel 2s. Again, $11.11, half off, so $5.50 for these Brooks. Next up, I got these UGG slip-ons. These are a men's size 10. I picked them up because they were only $7 plus a 25% discount, and we are getting into winter, so this seems like something that might be, the demand might be rising for, so I went ahead and picked these up for only around $5. So UGG, good brand, minimal cleaning, and shearling line, so coming into winter, these should sell pretty well. Next up, I got these FootJoys. I have sold this model in the past for around $70. Not this color, I sold it in black, but they were only $7. And all the spike with golf shoes, make sure all the spikes are still intact, and these are in great condition. Don't need much cleaning on these. So FootJoys, Dry Joys, leather with the croc skin right there. Definitely a good model of FootJoy to look out for. Next, picked up these Jack Purcell Converse. These are a laceless model, so don't need any laces for them. This nice cheetah print, they were only $7 after the half off discount, in amazing condition. Don't need much cleaning to get these listed. And lastly, one of my favorite finds was these Allbirds, in amazing condition. Just need a little magic eraser on the bottom and midsoles, and these are ready to go. These will sell very quick. I typically can't keep Allbirds in stock for longer than a few days to a week, so at $9 plus a 25% discount, this was a great pickup. So again, as for the shoe fund, we walked into today with $103.83 to spend on the shoes that I decided to use for the challenge from that thrift haul. I paid $87.72. And then on the supplies that we got at Walmart, the acetone, the pick, and the brush, we spent $9.08, bringing our shoe fund down from $103 to $7.03. So definitely a very good use of our money on the day. And then luckily, right as I sat down to record this video, a sale came through. And as I mentioned when I picked them up, these are the fastest selling New Balances. There are the 990s that we just picked up on Facebook Marketplace for $20, sold for $109 on Mercari. Only downside is they are going to California, so the shipping was a little expensive. But on the $109 sale, the fees we have to pay is $14.36. The shipping cost $12.44 from Florida to California, bringing the total net after shipping and fees down to $82.20. So $20 and $82 in less than 24 hours was an amazing pickup, an amazing flip. So adding that to the $7.03 that we had left over after today's sourcing, we are halfway through the week with $89.23 left in the shoe fund and a bunch of shoes that I need to get listed as soon as possible. So definitely an amazing day for the Closet to Profit series. Things are continuing to go amazing for the Closet to Profit series. I hope you guys see all of the opportunity that is out there, especially selling used shoes. So not sure what else is going to be on the agenda for this week. I might try to get out and spend this $89 that we have left over. But if not, got these shoes to get cleaned up, shouldn't take too long. I'll show you guys how we are going to use the new cleaning supplies, and then I'll get those listed as soon as possible. All right, so today we picked up a few cleaning items that I wanted to go over real quick. Before I hop into that, I do want to mention that if you're cleaning inside, I recommend getting something to clean into. I'm not counting this as part of the something that I'm picking up for the Closet to Profit series. If you don't have access to something to clean over, just go clean outside on your patio, wherever you live. Just find somewhere to make it happen, or you can honestly just clean and clean up the mess whenever you're done. Because when you're cleaning the shoes, obviously whatever you're cleaning off the shoes is going to fall somewhere. Just make sure that it's not making too much of a mess whenever you're doing so. So if you've seen in episode 2, we picked up a magic eraser. This is one of the most important tools when cleaning shoes. I use this all the time. This is great for cleaning the midsoles and really just any of the rubbery materials on shoes. So if you want to see that in use, make sure to go check out episode 2 of From the Closet to Profit series. Or if you want to see all of the tools that I use to clean shoes in my normal reselling business, I'll put a link on the screen to my how to clean shoes video that I have here on my YouTube channel. So today we picked up a couple things that are very, very necessary when cleaning shoes, and that is a pick and a brush. Now these look different than the ones I picked up today, because the ones I picked up today is for one of you guys. I already have these, so no need for me to pick up another one myself. The pick and the brush is used to clean off most of the loose dirt and anything that's really lodged in the tread of shoes. Now, up until this point, I've been having to pass on shoes that were that had a bunch of dirt on the bottoms of them. And some Brooks that I posted for sale actually had some rocks in the tread that were bugging me, but I knew for the challenge, since I didn't have a pick, I'd just leave them in there. They weren't too bad or too noticeable, so I went ahead and listed them with it. But now that we have this pick, it's gonna make cleaning up the bottoms of shoes much easier. Now, if you look at the bottoms of most shoes, the main issue is going to be rocks stuck in the tread. I don't know if you can see, but on the bottom of these, there's several rocks stuck in the tread, and this pick makes it super easy to just go in there and knock all of the rocks out. As well as if there's dirt clumped up, you can take the pick and really just loosen that dirt up. And then after you've knocked all the rocks out, loosen the dirt up, that is when the brush that we just bought comes in handy. You can literally just take it, wipe the shoes down a few times, and that 9 times out of 10 cleans up the shoes to a point of where they're ready to list. And then maybe if there's still some dirty spots, you can take that magic eraser that we got and rub them down. And then after that, they're definitely should be good to go. And then the last thing that we picked up today is this acetone or nail polish remover. This is great, as I mentioned before, on Converse and Vans that have this textured material on the midsole. If I'd use that magic eraser to clean it, while it probably would do the job after a while of going over the same spot over and over, it's gonna disintegrate this magic eraser a lot faster than a normal midsole would, because I've just found that this texture just really eats away at magic eraser. So instead, I use the acetone. I'll give you a before shot if you can tell how dirty that these Vans are. And then for the acetone, you'll just need a hand towel. Get a little bit on the towel, and then we'll just rub the midsole with that acetone, and it should take the dirt right off. And there we are. I'm not sure how well the camera is going to pick it up, but they are much better than they started out as. The midsoles are basically just back to white, not much signs of dirt, and it only took about 30 seconds of scrubbing. So as you can see, the first thing that we focused on when reinvesting our profit was into cleaning. In my opinion, that is the number one most important part when you are selling used shoes, because with used shoes, the only way to demand a higher price is condition. So when people are going on shopping and they're comparing some options, they're always gonna go with the shoes that are in better condition. So the first thing that I always recommend when investing is into cleaning supplies. We now have all of the cleaning supplies that, in my opinion, are the most important, the ones that I use most frequently. There's still a few that we are going to pick up. Not sure the order, but the next thing that I recommend on focusing on when reinvesting your money is into a good photography setup. You can go very inexpensive with this. You don't have to spend hundreds of dollars on good lighting equipment and a good background. We're gonna find a way to get something for cheap, make our pictures look a lot more professional, and I think that that will increase our sell-through rate exponentially. Even though we are already selling through our inventory very quickly, I think the next step is going to be upgrading the backdrop and the lighting and make everything look a lot better. But for now, we're sticking to the patio and the sunlight as our photo setup. So I'm gonna go finish cleaning these shoes up and then take them out and get them photographed and ready to list online. So a couple updates before we wrap up this week's episode. First off, we made 2 sales. First off, we sold the Converse that had the flame design on the side that we picked up a couple episodes ago from Goodwill for $2.99. They sold on Poshmark for $29, netting us $23.20. After fees. And then we also sold a pair of Brooks Pure Flow 6s that we picked up last episode. They sold on eBay for $35. So our net after shipping and fees are taken out was $21.55. So after those 2 sales, that brings our total shoe fund up to $133.98 to go sourcing with next week. And then another thing that I need to mention is I made a little bit of a mistake. So after those sales, we still have 20 pairs of shoes still in inventory, but we should have 21. These FootJoys that I picked up, one of my biggest problems when I'm outsourcing is I'm not thorough with every single pair of shoes. Hopefully you can take this mistake and learn from it. What you need to be doing when you're outsourcing is every single pair of shoes, you need to be twisting them. I did not do that on these shoes. And when I went to list them, I noticed the edges were kind of crumbling right here on this plastic part, and just a minor twist, it cracked right in half. So there was I don't know what you would call that. The plastic had hardened up so much that once I twisted it just barely on both pairs, they cracked right in half. So just something to look out for. Be thorough with all the shoes that you are sourcing. So unfortunately, that is $7 wasted on these shoes. What I normally do with shoes that I pick up that I can't sell, since the insoles are nice and the laces are nice, I'm going to pull those out of the shoes and just go re-donate these. So that sucks, but we still are ending the week on a good note. We have 20 items still in inventory, as well as the $133.98 to go sourcing with. But unfortunately, next week I will be out of town, so we are not going to have a From the Closet to Profit episode coming out next Monday, as well as the Monday after that. I'm going to be gone for 2 weeks, so we'll pick up the series 2 weeks from now when I get back to town. I'll do some filming. So it's going to be, I think, 3 weeks before we make it to episode 5. So with that being said, that wraps up this week's episode of From the Closet to Profit. The question of the day that you need to answer to be entered into the giveaway to enter the pick, the brush, and the acetone to use in your shoe cleaning is, what is your favorite platform to sell on? I know there's so many. My personal favorite platform is Poshmark, but I want to know what yours is. Drop that down in the comments below to be entered in this week's giveaway. If you're getting any value out of this series and you're enjoying watching the progression of From the Closet to Profit, leave a like on this video and hit the subscribe button if you haven't already, and turn on that notification bell so you get notified every time I post future videos. And that wraps up this week's episode, guys. I'll see you in the next one.